untuk hijau eh. Huyun, adakah hijau warna luaran anda? Okey. Tak pandang dulu. Sebelum saya cakap apa-apa, so you pakai lebih ke warna pink. So tapi doesn't mean you have to wear head to toe in pink lah. Sebab ni kan honey. So pick something yang akan enhance you punya diri. Contohnya tudung.
Fat. I can't see myself.
So with this, you can learn to overcome that systematically. So it's something that you can just remember the steps. Again, I'm all about steps. If you notice, remember the steps. You can keep on doing it over and over again for yourself, orang lain, terpulang. So sekali lagi saya nak volunteer. Kali ni orang lain pula. Jabat tangan lah. Kalau tak boleh nanti dia cakap haram lah. Haram tak payahlah kan. Yang perempuan-perempuan ni boleh lah.
Bukan perkara besar dekat Media Prima, gua di TV9. Tapi saya mengacau juga. Macam korang, saya pun pernah simpan impian, oh my, I want to be a TV host. I really wanted to host since I was in university. I'm a communication graduate. And then I went to France. I did a master's in international affairs. So I speak French. You kena kurangkan rasa malu. Bukan dalam Islam kata malu bertempat, right? So you have to have a certain amount of malu. Tapi don't overdo it lah. Okay, you kena malu bertempat. Tapi kalau nanti personality pun malu nak cakap dengan orang macam ni nak. Personality macam aku nak ask you a question. Tapi ada orang nak, dia minat. Saya tahu ramai orang, because saya kerja dengan ramai orang. Memang dia nak jadi TV host. Tapi bila suruh cakap, dia shy. Kita boleh tak jawab? Dia nak audition ni. Audition, tiba-tiba sekumpulan orang masuk, Zaz. Boleh tak I buat audition dengan dia orang je? Jangan dia orang kat luar. Eh babe, you want to be a TV host, right? The whole world will see you. The whole country will see you. So that is already a bad thing. Pada saya lah, you tak boleh nak kata macam alamak ada orang masuk tadi audition kata tiga orang. Jadi tiba kat saya, kenapa saya tiba satu bilik masuk? Itulah the true test of a TV personality. You takkan malu bila orang masuk. And I cakap you sekarang, saya mengacara majlis banyak dalam a few languages. Nak buat benda macam ni saya rasa lagi nervous. Saya pernah mengacara kat TV. Memang TV betul is live forever. Saya pernah mengacara di TV9 malam-malam. Saya macam, alam malam-malam tak orang tengok. Go to TV9 pukul 12, no one's watching. Then I found out people are watching like, oh Shah, we saw you last night. Or you did something, it's like a bit malu lah, right? And then bila TV, I rasa macam alam cakap dengan kamera. So it's actually yes, less rasa malu tu less. Tapi bila cakap depan orang, semua tengok. Buat salah je, habis lah kan tu. Everybody's gonna say something. But, like I said, you want to be a TV personality, you have to have some amount of confidence. Okay, you kena ada. And you tak boleh malu sangat. You cannot be too shy. Kalau I perlukan you to do something, you have to do it. And banyak kawan-kawan I yang I kenal dan jadi TV personality, whether dia big TV personality or small TV, walaupun dia hanya wartawan TV je, dia sini cakap, mula-mula tu nak buat liputan pun Shah nervous. Semua tengah tengok. Dia macam heboh punya tu. Masa aku cakap Media Prima tu, kena kena tengok. Dia orang kena buat stand up depan orang ramai lalu-lalang. Kita nampak dia macam, oh terror eh. Especially kalau orang season, dia tak ada hal. Hi, blah-blah-blah, saya sekarang berada ni, tak masalah langsung. Tapi while all this is going on, orang tengah tengok, orang tengok rambut you, muka you, damn, apa ni, annoying lah, I rasa. Okay, and then the pressure, it mounts up. So that's something you have to overcome, alright? So like I said, the do is, you have to have some amount of rasa malu, kena ada. Tapi you tak boleh malu sangat. Kalau you malu sangat, you susah sikit. Because saya rasa kalau you nak jadi personality, you shouldn't be somebody who's very shy, I suppose. It would defeat the purpose. Okay? Okay, so saya dah cakap, the confidence and then the personality and then of course physical appearance masuk sekali. Lepas tu, this feeling of shy. Next one, bila saya cakap shy ni, ada rasa humble tu lah yang maksud saya. I cakap waktu hiburan kali tapi tak suka orang cocky. We don't like people who are like, rasa dia bagus sangat. Eh, I dah mencari banyak pasal saya dah bekerja dengan ramai pengacara. Okay, saya dah interview, dah tulis tentang mereka, dah interview mereka. I'm very comfortable interviewing people in front of the camera. I love interviewing people. But from there, you know whether a person is like a true TV personality or just gila glamour aja. Okay? Bila orang nak jadi TV personality ni, dia ada satu drive tau. Saya pernah cakap dekat cousin saya, saya tak sebut nama lah. Dia minat yang tiba-tiba saya hati. So saya cakap dekat dia, saya cakap kat dia, okay, tapi you have, you apa lah, kalau saya salah word kau orang salah faham. You kena ada drive yang you nak a bit of the glam. You have to want that spotlight. Kau orang kata tak, jawapan klise eh, kalau orang bawa jadi pengacara, bawa orang macam, tak, saya ni memang minat saya, saya minat saya. Kenapa dia jadi personality? Because you want to be in front of TV, right? It's in front of TV, you cannot lie, you cannot deny. Kalau you cakap you tak nak, I tak percaya. And I selalu kata, you mesti ada that drive. You kena cakap, I want to be in front of the camera. I suka that spotlight, I suka that glam, that bit. Bukan glam yang dapat liputan, wartawan semua, bukan. The glam of being noticed. Bila you masuk je, orang tengok je you. Itu TV personality, tak payah cakap ada orang kerja lain, celebrities from other world, ada athletes. Dia pun popular, but some of them memang cakap dia tak suka all this, but they cannot help it. If you are in that industry, you will get it. So you can have that drive, the do's, I believe you have to want that bit of glam, that spotlight. Impossible kalau you tak nak. Because you nak keluar TV, right? TV tu, you won't be menarik. Kalau you, ada, I don't know kalau ada dekat sini pelajar communication macam I juga, broadcasting, yang pernah study. Okay, if you did, when I did, we had a subject called TV presenting, okay? And my lecturer, she's a psychology punya lecturer juga, she's a psychologist, okay? So dia pernah cakap, you have to know how to seduce the camera. Kalau you tak pandai seduce the camera, camera tak nak you. So that's why you kena, you nak that glam, you nak that spotlight. Kalau you macam, tak adalah, I'm just doing it with a passion, don't do that crap. Don't, I know what you want. You want to be in front of TV, because bila you nak berada di depan TV, you akan tunjukkan. And I punya lecturer, dia kata apa tau, I ingat lagi, dia kata, Syah, you know who's the best person who seduces the camera in Malaysia? Siti Nurhaliza. Lepas tu Siti baru keluar. Dia kata, she and her ayu, she senyum, she her lenggok kepala, she seduces camera very well. That's what my lecturer told me. And we all learn from her, we're like, ah, betul lah. Padahal Siti, you tahu tak, mula-mula, kan dia pemalu. Kan baru malu. Siti tak nak komen. You know? And she first started out. She had fashion malfunction, wardrobe salam, semua. She did everything. But she's a true star. She went through everything daripada kosong sampai sekarang. But daripada dia mula-mula keluar TV tu, lecturer I kata, you tengok tak Syah bila dia nyanyi? Malu-malu dia tu. Terus, the camera loves her. So you as a TV personality, you have to know how to use your audience. You have to know how to use your TV camera depan tu. And that's why I kata, you kena mahukan that bit of glam. You nak spotlight tu. So macam I cakap, walaupun I mengacara rancangan yang kecil-kecil, orang tak kenal, I tak boleh, because macam you all, my passion was to host a TV show. Gua di TV 9 ni appeal lepas pukul 11.30, 12 malam, nobody's watching. Bernama TV siapa yang tengok? I don't care. So I buat, because it's my passion. But then when you realize people are watching, you have to want that glam. I nak orang tengok my show juga, I nak feedback dari orang. I tak naklah berangan seseorang. Alah, tak bersangka pun. Okay, somebody has to give me feedback. So that is the do, okay? You have to want that bit of glam. You have to want the spotlight. The don'ts, like I said, don't be overconfident. Don't be cocky. You have to be nervous sedikit. Macam saya cakap, you tak nervous, impossible. You kena nervous juga. You dah terror macam mana pun you naik, you know. I'm giving an example. Saya akan bagi semua example yang betul eh. I give you all two examples pengacara live majlis atau dekat TV. Syah Al-Yahya, pengacara Anugerah Jawi Lagu baru-baru ni. As you all know, dia dah tak pengacara music lagi ada sebab. Because I think she's not a good host. I think she's a better actress. Okay? Nilofa, I think on the other hand, cannot act, she should host. Pada I lah. Nilofa. She's not my favourite actress anyway, but I think she hosts very well. I pun terkejut. Dia masa dia buat Nona macam, wow, Nilofa can host. Shah, on the other hand, husband dia pandai mengacara. Dia, I rasa pandai berlakon aja. And she was a stewardess. I mean, I shouldn't be stereotyping stewardess lah, but I rasa mungkin dia dah biasa, she's routine to do that. So, bila dia actress, you dah routine buat script, you buat, dia pandai. But okay, masih AJL recently, saya tercalon. Okay, ini bukan nak, I nak bagi example. Saya tercalon, lagu saya kan Alia Sesang Separuh Nyawa. The host, every masa saya calon Mahakarya Cinta Nusyarat sahabat sebut. Macam, the script dah sebut. Syah Al-Yahya sebut, lagu dicipta oleh Alfie Alwi dan dia lupa seorang lagi komposer dan lirik oleh Alia sendiri. Alia tulis dua baris je lagu tu. 98% I wrote that song. And she didn't mention me. And the show is about the composer dan penulis lirik. And sebagai seorang pesan TV, saya dah blacklist lah dia macam, that's not a good TV host. You're supposed to mention my name as well, right? It's not because I nak glamour, memang semua orang disebut. Bila nama I, dia lupa. Lepas tu bila keluar screen nama I ada. So then I tanya producer dia, kenapa? Alah, I cakap I terkilan, I cakap kat producer dia, kenapa she tak sebut nama I? Dia nervous, Syah. Syah nervous. So sebab tu next year no more, you're not going to see her on AJL anymore. Syahrul Samad tu ingat there was one year dia dah berhenti pengacara music, dia still panggil dia pengacara AJL. Because she's a really good host. Yeah. okay? Bukan pasal dia kawan rapat I, she is a close friend, tapi she is a good host. Cher does very well in English and Malay, she doesn't forget, she's on the spot, tip-top. Shah Alihaya is an actress. That's the difference between an actress and a TV personality, okay? But an actress has to have a certain amount of confidence as well. So, macam saya cakap, saya bagi contoh Shah tu sebab you mana boleh lupa you punya tu, dan dia ada cards, she had cue cards pun you lupa juga. Wartawan hiburan mesti kita hencap ni macam, okay Shah lupa. Don't say that, macam how could you do this? Tapi dia telah melakukan. So itu adalah bukti pengacara yang besar pun akan nervous juga. So kalau you are nervous, that's normal. Cuma I say you all kena buat homework, okay? That's a don't. That's why I say mungkin I tak tahu Shah overconfident atau apa, atau mungkin tak, mungkin dia just nervous, okay? Because she's a nice friend. Macam bila jumpa, she's very nice. Cuma I rasa dia lupa. Tapi I terkilan lah. Tu mungkin nama I tak tahu kalau ada lagi komposer lain dia lupa sebut nama malam tu. I tak tahulah. Tulis lirik. Okay? But it happened to Shah Alihaya. Mahathir Luqman, bigger bubu. Mahathir Luqman pengacara yang mungkin ada yang kenal dan tak kenal. Dia kononnya one of those yang multilingual lah. Okay, he speaks French, German. Tapi pasal saya pun cakap French, saya ketahui bahasa Perancis sebab salah. Okay, but anyway. Dia pernah mengacara satu event, gala, F1 gala. Masa malam tu, ada Diana Faiza, ada Leona Lewis. And then ada actors from Hollywood. I was there. There was Owen Wilson from Hollywood. As well as, there were two guys. I forgot the other one. But anyway, so malam tu pengacara dia Wan Zaliha Razi. You all kenal Wan Zaliha Razi?
Yes.
I think she's one of the best TV personalities ever. Okay? She was paired up with Mahathir Luqman. Ada Agung malam tu, ada Prime Minister semua. Nah, tu yang I cakap macam mana sebenarnya lagi nervous macam TV. So malam tu dia buat, dia protocol dia lah, bla 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 bla. Lepas tu Wan Zaliha Razi, oh terima kasih bla bla bla. Lepas tu she did it in both English and Malay. Dan dia kata, and of course I'm even more thrilled because my favourite actor Owen Williams is here tonight. Tu dia cakap, Owen Williams. Sama mamak tu Owen Wilson eh. Dia sebut 3 kali ke 4 kali, Owen Williams, Owen Williams. And then somebody went backstage, kata, what is wrong with Leha? Dia panggil Leha backstage. What's wrong with Leha? His name is Owen Wilson, he's a Hollywood actor. Lepas tu dia cakap kat orang, dia nak propah, my favourite actor. Would you really get your favourite actor's name wrong 4 times? I ask you. No, right? You takkan. So tu yang kan kawan I actor, masa tu kata, Shah, that's overconfidence. That's a don't of a TV personality. She can do majalah 3 very well, but she salahkan nama orang. Owen Wilson, mamak tu macam gelak aje. Malu tak depan Hollywood? Now the whole Hollywood, masa datang, oh these are the two of our best TV hosts, blah blah blah. When they got my name wrong. And he's not in one movie, he's been so many movies tau nama dia. Owen Wilson, orang sebut Owen Williams. Lepas tu Mahathir Luqman pun cuba nak cover lah untuk dia. Oh, she was so nervous and excited because she loves Owen Wilson and Prince William, so she got the two mix up. Nak propa pun propa lah kalau cik sikit. Kau tak bodoh. So on that day I realised, as like saya cakap, saya mengacara rancangan TV kecil-kecil je, pernah TV and then internet TV and then Wani TV 9. Tapi of course I looked up for her. Malam tu terus saya realised, so it's true, she's not as good as you think. Pasal saya punya mentor, dia pembaca berita juga, nama dia Anne Edwards. Some of you may know her. Dia baca berita dekat TV 1, 2, 3. So she's done it all lah. So she used to tell me, Shah, you're very talented. If you tak percaya you're talented, no one will believe you're talented. I rasa I ada bakat lah, I boleh cakap. Okay, I think I can talk well. I have a rather reasonable amount of personality, so I think I can be in front of the camera. Tapi I tak yakin macam I'm so hebat. Tapi masa malam tu pula I tengok Wan Zaliha Razi pun buat salah. And dia dah mengacara masa I sekolah rendah lagi tau. You all berlahir je, setengah tu maybe some of you belum lahir lagi. Because I'm old, I'm repeating that. I'm mature lah, mature. But yeah. So kalau Wan Zaliha Razi yang dah bertahun-tahun pun mengacara buat salah, there is nothing wrong to you all buat salah. Tapi itulah bukti dia. Overconfidence, okay, being cocky, not being prepared, that's what happens. Sebab tu you can have a certain level of intelligence. That's the last do's and don'ts yang I nak bagi tahu lah. Okay, because but it's not the last part of my apa ni presentation. Kita masih ada buat tu lagi. I'm going to play some games with you guys, right? But I'm just saying, a TV personality becomes more attractive bila dia ada that amount of intelligence. Okay, saya cakap terus-terang sekali lagi, ini adalah kenyataan yang mungkin perit untuk diterima, tapi anda perlu terima. Tak semua orang yang tampil depan TV bijak, tapi dia pandai depan TV. Kita tahu knowledge tu ada different kan, orang lain pada maths, orang lain pada cakap, different. Okay, some people communicate very well although they're not very smart. Saya rasa saya macam almost lah, macam I'm not very clever but clever enough lah, okay? But a person who's very clever will look so attractive depan kamera, TV personality. Bila you macam tahu sikit, because selalunya dia kata yang terror pengacara ni, dia mungkin tidak sebijak sangat aku tidak sebijak mana. Tapi the moment you bagi dia through any topic, dia boleh jawab. Sebab tu dia kata bila dia buat all these rancangan yang mencari pengacara, pengacara jumpa temona lah apa benda, they throw you in a situation, are you going to present? Okay, pergi sini. Okay, sekarang saya berada di ni 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 ni, you just throw and that is normal. Okay, how many of you here have been to TV auditions? Can you please put up your hands? Okay, TV personality belum bawa acting, okay? So, acting is different. Acting is different, like I said, there's a script and everything, alright? And sometimes? Bila you audition for TV hosting, it's typical. Dia akan bagi situation or they suruh, okay, sekarang anda punya assignment adalah bayangkan, it depends what show you're doing. Banyak orang sekarang lagi satu, I notice lah semua orang nak cakap hiburan. Everybody wants to be an entertainment TV host, okay? Okay, that's different. An entertainment TV host at the same time, I rasa, that one you can take an actor. You can take an actor. But of course, it's rehearsed lah. Saya pernah dulu jadi manager Fazura. Before I started writing her lyrics, when I used to manage her, she was MTV VJ, so we would fly to Singapore every 2 weeks now. And then, Faz, you know, Faz is an actress. She was pelakon harapan. First film dia dapat pelakon harapan. So, masa I mula-mula manage dia dulu, VJ dekat the team in Singapore put her. She does in English and Malay as well, ya. Yeah? So, masa tu dia letak dalam kamera. Okay, banyak orang tak tahu kalau jadi pengacara ni ada teleprompter. Okay, teleprompter ni akan keluar, you baca je. Nampak macam, wow, daring Muhammad ni, fasih gila. Padahal there's a prompter going on. You're reading. Okay, a good actor or TV personality pun boleh cakap akan make it look like they're not reading. Dia boleh memang nampak macam, wow, dia bercakap. A bad one, okay, they do that. So when Faz did it, I noticed, wow, okay, she does it so well. There's a prompter. But she's an actress, so she pandai lah macam orang-orang buat macam tu. So I cakap dekat dia, okay, bila I suruh dia buat on the spot, she's not very good. I mean, she's not a TV personality. But she's an actress. She's an actress. So I cakap kat dia, gee, I think you should stick to acting. I cakap kat dia, I'm being honest. Because I was a manager then. I cakap kat dia, I think you should stick to acting. I cakap, you act better than you host. Not that you can't host. Of course, you boleh buat host event, tak ada masalah. Tapi dia punya periuk nasi dia, saya cakap, this is too strength dia. She should do that. So kalau you all pergi audition, memang dia akan suruh buat macam tu. Okay, now you berada satu situasi. Especially kalau yang rancang yang serious, all this macam tu betul-betul macam 3R cakap hari tu. Or you do a business show, okay, terangkan tentang GST. Mati tau. Government sure tutup GST. So you go and GST adalah, so you have to come prepared, okay. So the intelligence kena ada. Tapi ada setengah orang memang dia tak ada intelligence sangat, tapi dia pandai bercakap. Dia baca, mungkin dia terbaca-terbaca je. Okay, GST merupakan satu cukai perkhidmatan yang bakal dikenakan kepada rakyat, dan ramai tak setuju, tapi dia membebel. Tapi benda tu not really, there's no apa content in it. But the person pandai cakap, so dia lepas. Tapi kalau person tu ada intelligence, dia cakap memang it will look more attractive. Akan kelihatan lebih menarik because dia cakap tu ada isi. So sebab tu kata the do's and don'ts, these are the simple do's and don'ts lah macam yang cakap. First of all is your confidence. Okay, jangan overconfident sangat. Secondly, ada personality. You kena nak look good. You akan dress well, you know what to do with your tudung, your hair, whatever you're wearing when you go for an audition. And the third one, you have to have
acara. Jadi, tidak mustahil walau dalam bidang apa sekalipun yang anda ceburi, yang penting anda kena tahu niat itu. Adakah terus ingin menjadi wartawan penyiaran? Adakah terus ingin menjadi penerbit? Adakah mahu menjadi penerbit eksekutif?
Sebab it's happening now, so I'm going with it. Yeah.
Tetapi ramai yang saya kira nak tahu, mungkin dah jadi orang yang terkenal dalam bidang nyanyian ini, ada peminat yang tersendiri. Apa antara perubahan ketara yang Elizabeth dapat rasakan bila Elizabeth sendiri menjadi sebahagian daripada anak seni?
Saya rasa perubahan yang terbesar is schedule. Schedule sekarang padat gila, and when you masuk industry ni and you will have very little time for yourself, very little time for your own friends, especially starting out, mana mula-mulanya you kena lah bagi 100% untuk focus career you. You tak boleh fikir for yourself, you know, what you want. And that's what, this is my management during yang advice I, so I pun bagi kat korang lah. This is, yeah.
Kebiasaannya kalau kita dah bergelanak,
abaikan ku, yeah. Jadi jaga dah.
Okay, kakak rasa kakak tak cute lah. Kakak tak elok. So it's cute and she does it. I rasa kalau I buat, orang ni buat tak cute kot. Tapi itu okay. Dan orang kata adalah cara nak cover dia tengah berfikir. Okay, orang rasa, I ingat lagi. Lagi satu orang dah cakap dekat I, Syah, you cakap cepat sangat. Itu sebenarnya dia kata orang yang cakap cepat pun cara dia nak cover dia punya nervous juga. Sebab tu dia cakap cepat. I kata, ya ke? Cheryl Samad, Sarimah Ibrahim, Syah Syamsiri. We talk very fast. Okay? But I think they are very good TV hosts. So bukan pasal dia nervous, it's just their style. So saya rasa saya cakap cepat style dia. Now the and arms will only happen kalau betul-betul you tak bersiap sedia. I pun ada kadang-kadang ada dan arm juga. Dan sebagai apa ni, as a YouTube punya host lagi lah, you buat on the spot sahaja. Benda-benda YouTube internet ni, kita tak prepare macam TV dah. Ada rundown, ada prompter. Dan arm tu akan ada. Tapi masalah nak mengurangkan dan arm tu memang susah. Kalau I have no other solution other than being extra prepared. Because kalau I cannot hide, because I can say even a professional will have an and arm. Okay? Tapi gagap adalah practice. I tahu memang pernah pergi again kelas dekat universiti, lecture cakap gagap you have to do a lot of, dia kata kadang-kadang you saja read out loud, membaca dengan kuat. Itu I tahu, lecture I bagi tahu. Dia kata okay, you baca teks ni kuat-kuat, you baca berkali-kali. Okay, for instance, I'm reading that Shah Shamsiri do's and don'ts, a TV personality from the media perspective. The constant repeating of a certain paragraph, okay, is to, just to get your, you know, those little mouth exercises, okay? Itu untuk hilangkan gagap. Because bila you cakap, yang dan am tu bukan gagap. Dan am is not gagap. Dan am is just you being nervous dan kita tersangkut dalam nak tanya apa. Yang blank tu pun terjadi kepada semua orang. Zia Nazir pernah lupa lirik lagu dia dekat separuh akhir music, okay? Dia, she's a big star and she forgets her own lyrics. Okay, so pengacara Syah Ahli-Ahli macam cakap, dah ada cue card pun lupa, blank. Lupa. Ada cue card ni lupa. Okay, then ada Wazaliha Razi salah sebut nama orang. So, this blank thing pun saya rasa happens bila you, how do I say terbawa-bawa or you lose focus. If you really engage that person, I takkan lose focus. Macam right now, I cakap dengan korang, tapi kalau lama, I dah macam